Hello students, good morning. Here we are again to continue with our program on this course AEM 503. And on today's class, we'll be looking at unit 3 and 4. Okay? And in looking at unit 3 and 4, we are taking the units the way they are because we have to really cover the work into two. Unit 3 looks at the process of adoption. And by the time we'll be ending the unit 3, the students should be able to talk so much in way of identifying and discuss the stages involved in the adoption process of any innovation, especially in where agri is concerned. While unit 4 will be looking at diffusion of innovation. And of course, at the end of the unit 4, the students should be able to explain the concept of the diffusion process of innovation and as well discuss the major stages involved in the different stages of the diffusion of innovation process. It's going to be beautiful. I just encourage you to make yourself available, attend classes, and I'm sure you understand it very well and it will help you in the course of this study. Thank you and stay good. Good afternoon, this is the course lecturer, Dr. Mukhen Godi, on this course AEM 503. Today we'll be treating unit 3 and 4, and the first one here is the process of adoption. In talking about the process of adoption, we start with the introduction. The decision to adopt an innovation is not normal, it's not normally a single instantaneous act. In other words, what we are saying here is that it is something that takes time. It is a decision-making process involving a period of time during which an individual goes through a number of mental stages before making a final decision to adopt an innovation. This situation is better explained in terms of stages of adoption and innovation decision process. Hence, technologies are either completely or partly new and are often expected to replace this. The intended learning outcomes of the students are, students will be able to, at the end of this course, identify the stages involved in adoption process and discuss various stages or steps involved in adoption process. 3.1, talking about process of adoption. Diffusion of innovation within a social system takes place through its adoption by individuals or group of people. Adoption is a decision to make full use of an innovation as the best course of action available. The decision to adopt an innovation involves a process composed of learning, deciding, and acting over a period of time, and that is why we say it takes time because it's not an instantaneous thing. The adoption process as a decision-making process goes through a number of mental stages before making a final decision to adopt an innovation. Stages of adoption are usually 5 in number, and these are the awareness stage, the interest stage, the evaluation stage, the trial stage, and the adoption stage. Interest, which has to be created, and of course, and after the evaluation, comment the stage. All right, and after that, we'll be looking at some questions which the students themselves have to pay attention. We will leave that first. When we complete the unit 4, then they will do them together. Okay? And so, in concluding generally, adoption of an innovation as a process is composed of learning, deciding, and acting over a period of time. You see, he has to learn what has been told to him, and he has to decide whether to adopt or not to adopt, and of course, all of this take time. The adoption of a specific practice is not the result of a single decision to act, but series of actions and thought decisions. Okay? That takes us to Unit 4, which is diffusion of innovation. The word diffusion of innovation is a theory that seeks to explain how, why, and at what rate new ideas and technologies spread through cultures, right? And so, diffusion and adoption are closely interrelated, but emphatically speaking, they are not the same. That is to say, at the end of this unit 4, students should be able to explain the concept of diffusion process of innovation, and they should be able to discuss the major stages involved in this diffusion of innovation. Talking about the concept of diffusion of innovation, as said before, is a theory that seeks to explain how, why, and at what rate new ideas and technologies spread through cultures. Everett Rogers defined diffusion of innovation as the process by which an innovation is communicated through certain channels over time among members of a social system. That is to say that diffusion goes through particular persons and over a particular period of time. And that's why we say it is not instantaneous, but it takes time. And these people are within a social system. Diffusion of innovation refers to the spread of those innovations through a population, and it is simply the result of a host of individual adoptions. Now, coming to the stages of diffusion of innovation. According to Derry 2008, diffusion occurs through a combination of effort, through a combination of factors. And this combination of factors are, number one, the need for individuals to reduce personal uncertainty when presented with new information. Get it right, the need of individuals to reduce personal uncertainty, okay, when presented with new information. That is to say, they should be open-hearted when confronted with new information. The need for individuals to respond to their perceptions of what specific credible others are thinking and doing. And of course, general felt social pressures to do as others have. Diffusion process of an innovation. The diffusion process of an innovation thus involves four stages. And these four stages, it must be stressed here that in some cases we say five stages, meaning to say one of the stages have been split into two, and that is the early adopters stage. And so, in talking about the process, the first there is the innovators. And the innovators are those people who are the initiators of the change. And we say this is the first stage. And at this stage, only few innovative farmers try out and adopt the innovation after its introduction in a village setting. Okay? The stage two are the early adopters. This is the second stage. And of course, a larger number of farmers, but still a small majority in the village, is influenced by the innovators that influenced by the first group to adopt the recommended. The third stage are the late adopters. All right, it is primarily this stage is primarily influenced by the early adopters. You can see we call them late adopters. So we can see that one level or one group is always influencing the other. And so we say they are influenced by the early adopters and make the large majority of the farmers in the village called the late adopters. They adopt the innovation, and like we have said before, they constitute the third stage. Alright? The fourth stage are the laggards. These laggards are people who don't want to take risks. Okay, they don't want to take risk, they don't want to try until others have finished their try, and they must have seen the reason why they want to try. Okay, so they are not risk takers, and that's why they are usually very few, and of course they are of very low socioeconomic characteristics. All right, and so we say that the laggards are a small group of farmers who take the longest time to adopt an innovation, and the laggards. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll come to a conclusion by saying that the diffusion process is a social phenomenon by which innovation is communicated through certain channels over time among members of a social system. There is always a variation among the members of a social system in the way they respond to an innovation idea or plan. God bless. Meanwhile, the tutor marked assessment or assignment is there for you to look at, and it will help to boost your performance in where this course. Thank you for listening, and God bless.